السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Today we're taking another system. It's a cartilage and bone histology. At the beginning, we must be explained that both of cartilage and bone, it's a specialized connective tissue. We entering at the cartilage, and as we know, we have a three type of cartilages. Number one, hyaline cartilage. Number two, elastic cartilage. Number three, fibrocartilage. As general, the whole of the matrix of the cartilage, it's containing a special cells. It's called, as we see, these called a lacuna. Inside the lacuna, we can find a chondrocyte. So the specific cells that's located at the cartilage, it's called chondrocyte. Chondrocyte that's located at the occupied itself by a cavity is called lacuna. Okay. Also, the substances of the cartilage, it's neither vascularized and not be supplied by nerves and lymphatic vessels. So, how it can receive their nourishment? It can be received their nourishment by the blood vessels of the surrounding connective tissues, by the diffusions. Okay. Okay. Type number one, hyaline cartilage. When we look at the fresh slide, we can find it in a bluish gray in color. When we can find the hyaline cartilage, we can find the hyaline cartilage at the nose, larynx, ventral ends of the rib, also that's articulate with the sternum, in the tracheal ring and bronchi, also at the articulating surface of the movable joints of the body. At this cartilage, also we can find it that's forming the cartilage of the template of long bones during the embryonic development and constituting the epiphyseal plate of growing long bones. Okay. So these are the whole matrix of the cartilage, of hyaline cartilage. These cells are resting on the matrix. This matrix located into two types or two layers. That's called territorial and interterritorial matrix. The territorial matrix that's covering each lacunae, okay? Each lacunae, it's called territorial. While the whole matrix of the cartilage, it's named interterritorial matrix. Also, the chondrocytes inside the lacunae can be located individuals like this, or can be accumulated as a groups. At this time, we can name it isogenes, as the isogenes. Okay. Before the matrix of this cartilage, we can find a layer. We name it the perichondrium. These are the perichondrium. What is the function or this perichondrium responsible for what? Responsible for the growth and maintenance of the cartilage. Why? Because the perichondrium it's يعني containing a fibers like what? Like collagen fibers and fibroblasts and a blood vessels that's supplied the matrix of the cartilage. And it can be divided into the outer fibrous layer. Okay. And inner cellular layer. And the inner cellular layer that's containing the chondrogenic cells. The chondrogenic cells. Okay. احنا قلنا انه الماتريكس of the highly cartilage containing a collagen fibers type 1. Also it can be located a collagen type 2. Okay. Now we coming at the number 2. This image is explain the lacuna inside it, the chondrocyte, and it can be find, we can find it as the isogenes groups or individuals like this. Okay. Type number 2, elastic cartilage. When we can find the elastic cartilage, we can find it at apina of the ear, external and internal auditory tube, also at the epiglottis and the larynx, when the larynx build cuneiform cartilage. So, because of the presence of the elastic fibers, elastic cartilage is somewhat a yellow and it's more than hyaline cartilage in the fresh state. Okay, so because of the presence of the elastic fibers, it gave it a yellowish color. Okay, elastic cartilage is identical to the hyaline cartilage and it's often associated with it. The outer fibrous layer of the perichondrium is rich in elastic fibers and the matrix of the elastic cartilage possesses abundance of the fine to coarse branching of elastic fibers. That's interpreted with the type 2 collagen fiber spandrels. That's giving it a much more flexibility than the matrix of the hyaline cartilage. So because of present of the elastic, that's make this type of cartilage, it's more flexible. Okay. Also, we can find this lacuna inside it, the chondrocyte and territorial and interterritorial matrix. Also, we can find the perichondrium, as we previously talking about it, by its inner and outer outer fibrous and inner cellular layer. The last type of the cartilages, it's a fibrocartilage or fibrous cartilage. The main characteristic feature of this type, it's absent of the perichondrium. So we can never ever find a perichondrium at this type of cartilage. When we can find this type of cartilage, we can find it at the intervertebral disc and the also at the pubic symphysis, also in the articular disc, and it can be attached to the bone. It's associated also with a hyaline cartilage and with a dense connective tissue. Its matrix also containing amount of the bundles of collagen type 1 fibers. Also the chondrocyte of the fibrocartilage usually arises from the fibroblast. At the site of the intervertebral disc, each disc are containing a gelatinous center that's called a nucleus pulposus. Okay, nucleus pulposus. So, these pulposus are surrounded by annulus fibrosus. This layer of the fibrous cartilage, it's rich in collagen fibers. It's run vertically between the hyaline cartilage of the two vertebrae. Okay. هذا كله فيما يخص عندنا المين characteristic features of the fibrocartilage. When we coming at the bone, histologically, at the bone also it has two layers from the outside and inside. The layers that's surrounding the bone or the whole matrix of the bone, we name it a periosteum. It's the external surface. Okay? It's consisting outer layer of dense fibrous connective tissue and inner cellular layer containing osteoprogenitor cells or sometimes called osteogenic cells. So that can be differentiated into the osteoblasts. Also, we can find a bundles of the collagen fibers from the periosteum that's known as a Sharpey fibers. So, we can find at the periosteum two layers. Outer layer, it's dense fibrous, containing also osteoprogenitor, osteoblast, and the fibrous collagen fiber, fibers we know or we call it a Sharpey fibers. Okay. Also, we can find at the outer layer. Also, we can find the endosteum. This endosteum, it's covering the cavities from the inside, the central cavity of the bone. Okay? It's lined by a monolayer of the osteoprogenitor cells, also osteoblasts. Okay. At the bone, it's composed from the cells that's lying at the extracellular matrix. These cells are become calcified. And the calcified matrix, it's composed from the fibers and ground substances. The fibers are constituting the bone and primarily type 1 collagen, while the ground substances are rich in proteoglycan. Also, we can find phosphorus, or can also we can find the osteonectin, osteocalcin. And we can divide the matrix, the bone matrix, and its content into the inorganic and organic components. The inorganic, sorry, component, which is constituting about 65% of the dry weight of the bone. It's composed mainly of calcium, phosphorus, also including bicarbonate, citrate, magnesium, sodium. And there is a making a complex between a calcium and a phosphorus that exists the or its result, a hydroxyapatite crystals, and these hydroxyapatite crystals, it's giving give the bone to be the hardest and very strong substances. And when we the bone is decalcified, يعني شنو decalcified, the mineral is removed from the bone it's will be a flexible and it's look like a tough rubber. An organic component that constituting about 35% of the dry weight. It's including fibers like collagen type 1 fibers. Also, previously we talking can be find a bone cell protein, osteopontin, osteocalcin, and another component. As a histologically واللي يهمنا احنا بهذا ال as a histology we have a four type of cells that's located at the bone matrix واللي هي شنو اللي هي ال osteoprogenitor cells or we can call it osteogenic cells osteoplast number two number three osteocyte number four osteoclast. Number one, osteoprogenitor cells. It's located at the inner cellular layer of the periosteum. Also, it's lining the Heuvergen canal. هذا بعدين راح نيجي نتكلم عنه بالcompact bone. Also, at the endosteum. These cells are derived from what? From the embryonic mesenchyme, and it's remain in the at the same place through the postnatal life, and it can be undergo a mitotic division and have the potential to differentiate into the osteoplasts. يعني مستقبل هذه ال osteoprogenitor at the future it's transformed to be osteoplast. Number two, osteoplast. تمام. بالنسبة للأوستيوبلاست, البلاست, sorry, located on the surface of the bone, it's look like as a sheet-like arrangement of a cuboidal to columnar cells. Osteoplast extended a short processes that make a contact with those of a neighboring osteoplast. يعني osteoplast with neighbor osteoplast, making a long processes that make the contact with the processes of the osteocyte. هذه الاوستيوبلاست this structure that gave us the matrix, the whole matrix of the bone. By the exocytosis, their secretory product. Each cell that surrounded itself with the bone matrix that is just produced when this occurring, that's incarcerated cells and referred and asked to be osteocytes. These osteocytes also occupies inside a cavities like the chondrocyte. Also, it's called lacunae. At this image, it's not be cleared. Okay, this slide or this image. These are each one of these one. It's represented the osteocyte that's occupied by a lacuna, or lacuna inside it, the osteocyte. Okay. An osteocyte derived from what? Derived from the osteoclast. We talking about it previously. As we see, there is a structure, it's called a canaliculi. It's look like a tunnel like. A tunnel like. It's considered a house of cytoplasmic processes of the osteocyte. These processes make a contact with the similar processes of the neighbor osteocyte. تشوفون بهذا الشكل. هذه تنطينا contact between the neighbor osteocyte to the osteocyte by these extended canaliculi. هذه الفاين. تشوفوا هذه الشعرات جدا رقيقة. الشعرات الرقيقة. هذه we name it the canaliculi. Okay. Also, another importance of this canaliculi that's containing the extracellular fluid that's carrying the nutrition and metabolized to the osteocyte. Okay. The last type of the bone cells, it's the osteoclast, which is considered a multinucleated cells. Also, it's originated from the granulocyte macrophage progenitor, and it's playing a very important role at the bone resorption and remodeling. Okay. Each one of this structure is called a haversian system. Okay, these are a haversian system, and these are also a haversian system. It's the same structure and component, a haversian system. Okay, when we coming at the main component of the compact bone. At the compact bone, previously we talking that it's lined from the outside and inside by the periosteum with its two layers. Outer and inner, outer fibrous and inner cellular, that's having the osteoprogenitor cells, and the inner, that's lined the cavities inside the bone. In addition to this periosteum and endosteum, there is also covered by a lamellar layer. Okay, or we call it a circumferential lamellae. circumferential lamelli، حتى تسمعوها زين والسبيلينج مالتها تعرفون تكتبوها. So we have the outer circumferential lamelli and inner circumferential lamelli. Okay. Also we have the interstitial. These are inside and between these a wafer like. This wafer like structure is called a Haversian system. And the between these systems, it's called the interstitial lamelli. At the outer circumferential lamelli, we say it's deep to the periosteum and forming the outermost region of the diaphysis and containing a Sherpae fibers that's anchoring to the periosteum of the bone. While the inner circumferential lamelli, it's also analogous to the outer, but it's not be extensive as the outer. It's completely encircled the bone marrow, as we see. Circling to the bone marrow and the trabecular lamellar of the spongy bone. These are starting with the spongy bone, this slide or this section. Also is interrupting the endosteal lining of the inner circumferential lamellae. We say that each one of these are constituting the Haversian system. And the whole of these Haversian systems, it's constituting the compact bone. Okay? So it's containing the periosteum, outer circumferential, and inner, also endosteum and inner inside it. And each one of these are the Haversian system. And the lamellae that's located between the systems and another systems, it's called interstitial lamellae. And these are the, this is the, sorry, the Haversian system. At the center is called the Haversian canal, lined by a very rounded, many of rounds that's containing, each one of this containing the osteocyte inside a lacuna. And we said that the connection between the osteocyte to another osteocyte by these canaliculi. Okay. And the connection between the system to another system, it's called Volkmann canal. Okay. The connection between this system with this and this with this, it's called a Volkmann canal. Okay. Type number two. كل اللي تكلمنا عنه الكلام السابق هو يخص ال compact bone. So when I ask you about the compact bone, تقول لي هو يكون a Haversian system, a bulky of a Haversian systems. While when we coming at the spongy bone, we cannot find the Haversian canal or Haversian systems. It's look like a trabeculae or alamillar. شوف هاي تشوفها as alamillar bony and between them or between these trabeculae it's adipose tissue, yellow bone marrow. Okay. And these lamellae also containing the osteocyte inside lacuna only. We cannot find the habergen system through these lamellae of this spongy bone. Just we can find the osteocyte inside the lacuna. Okay? And it's we taking talking sorry it's surrounding the bone marrow, yellow bone marrow, which is also have another type, red, that's containing a blood cells forming, and the yellow that's composing mostly of the fat, like this image. Okay, the last part of our lecture, including the bone ossification. We have the endochondral bone formation, and we have the primary that's begin at the middle of the cartilage, and secondary that's completed at the epiphysis. Okay, we started starting with the primary center ossification. أريدكم تكونون جدا منتبهين وياي بهذه الايفنتس جدا مهمة. هذه عندنا أول شيء البرايمري. بالنسبة للبرايمري شو راح يصير الأوسيفيكيشن؟ Here we have a cartilage. Okay. We have a cartilage. So this model is grow both appositionally and interstitially for a period time. Chondrocyte in the center of this cartilage is hypertrophy and accumulate of glycogenes in their cytoplasms, and it can become evacuated. So this hypertrophy of this chondrocyte resulting it in enlargement of their lacuna. Okay, as we see here, it can be enlargement of its lacuna. At the perichondrium, we know the cartilage is surrounded by the perichondrium, its whole matrix. At the midriff of these diaphyses, يعني long of the bone, or هنا بعد ما متكون عندنا البone, the mid of the cartilage, it's become avascularized. هنا راح تبدي عندنا تمتد بال highly vascularized. So when this is happened, the chondrogenic cells, it's become osteoprogenitor cells. يعني لما تجي عندنا, أنا رح أتكلم شوية بالعربي حتى جدا أن تكون أنت تفهم هذا الإيفنتس اللي تصير عندي. So we have a cartilage and it's have a lacuna. تمام؟ Inside the lacuna, the chondrocyte. When it's highly avascularized, like this image or this tape, these chondrogenic or chondrocytes, it's enlarged. And at the second stage, the perichondrium, it's transformed to be a periosteum. Okay? It can be transformed from the perichondrium to the periosteum. Okay. And with the vascular, the osteoprogenitor cells, it can be differentiated to forming the osteoblasts. And the portion of the overlying perichondrium become periosteum, as we said. The newly formed of the osteoblast secreted bone matrix to forming the subperiosteal bone collar. Okay. هذه الاوستيوبلاست هذه الاوستيوبلاست تمام راح تجي عندنا تكون لنا فد ستراكشر احنا نسميه سبيريوستيال سبيريوستيال بون كولر يعني around these cartilage okay surrounded these cartilage هذه الكولر راح تجي شو تسوي عندنا راح تجي تسوي عندنا a template of the intermembranous bone formation and this color prevent the diffusion of the nutrition and hypertrophied chondrocyte with the core of the cartilage module that's causing them to die so it's gonna be die these chondrocytes this process is responsible for present these chondrocytes it can be empty يعني شنو اللي راح تبقى عندنا راح تبقى عندنا فقط اللاكونه اللاكونه هذه تكون empty from inside يعني الكوندروسايتس it's can gonna be die تمام زين here the holes etching in the bone collar by the osteoclast هنا راح يجي دور rules of the osteo of the osteoclasts هذه شو راح تسوي لنا راح تسوي لنا itching للperiosteum من ناي راح تسوي بيها نحت او تتاكل شويه شويه حتى تسوي لنا فتحات تدخل من عندها هذه الهايلي فاسكولر تمام هذه الهايلي فاسكولر بعدين شنو اللي راح يصير This osteoclast that permits to forming the periosteal pads. These periosteal pads, اللي هي نقصد بيها osteogenic pads, composing شنو؟ شنو راح تحوينا هذه pads؟ Osteoprogenitor cells والhemopoietic cells, also blood vessels, that's to enter the cavities with the cartilage module. مثل ما تكلمنا عنها اذا هذه البادز لما راح تجي تصير لنا اتشنج للبيريوستيوم لان هي تحولت من البيريكوندريوم للبيريوستيوم باي ذا هايلي فاسكولار هذه البادز راح تجي تدخل لنا هيموبويتيك سيلز وراح تدخل لنا اوستيوبروجينيتور سيلز وبنفس الوقت بلاد فاسلز زين The osteoprogenitor cells that's divided to forming more osteoprogenitor cells, some of which that differentiate into the osteoblasts. طبعا هذه الاوستيوبلاست شنو الامبورتنس مالتها حتى تكمل لنا الماتريكس of the cells. Okay. Also, it can be differentiated to be the osteocyte. حتى also تكون لنا الاوستيوسايت. تمام وعندنا بال subperiosteal bone collar increased in thickness also grows in each direction that's from the midriff of the diaphysis toward the two epiphyses تمام يعني along the bone Osteoclast, it's begin to resorb the calcified cartilage, يعني ما راح يبقى عندنا cartilage. Also the cartilage bone complex. Enlargement of the bone marrow cavity. And at this process is continuous, the cartilage of the diaphysis is replaced by bone. كل هذا راح يكون إلى replaced، يعني راح يتحول transformed from the cartilage to the bone. طبعا except for the epiphyseal plate. Just this region راح تبقى عندنا هي تكون cartilage. اوكي اللي هنا يا هذا عندنا فيما يخص البرايمري. لما راح يجي يبدي عندنا السكندري، هذا السكندري وين يشتغل؟ works at the remaining of the cartilage at the epiphysis. تمام زين. These secondary begin to form at the epiphysis at each end, as we said, except that the bone collar it's not formed. Osteoprogenitor cells invade the cartilage of the epiphysis that differentiate into the osteoclasts. نفس العملية راح تتكرر. Entering of the vascular, okay, and secreting the matrix by the osteoclast. Also, the events take place and process, much they do to the as the diaphysis, and the cartilage of the epiphysis is replaced to a bone, except at the articular surface. بس بالarticular surface it's remain. تمام. And this processes of the epiphyseal it's gave the control of the bone long. Okay. Also this another image that's let's mention the bone ossification from the mesenchymal cells that differentiate into the chondrocyte, also forming of the periosteum and entering of the highly vascular that's forming a bed or a pad. That's entering the osteoprogenitor cells and hemopoiesis and the blood vessels inside this cartilage and transforming from the chondrogenic or chondrocyte to the osteocyte and osteoclast. And at the finally beginning of the secondary at the epiphysis, two ends, and until completing of a whole bone. And thank you very much. We reach at the last of our lecture.